What's up, world? It's your boy Xavier Truesdell, aka Sexy Black Chef. And today we're in my kitchen because I'm going to show you guys how to make a quick and easy meal for your family to enjoy. Today, I'm going to make baked mac and cheese, baked chicken, and cabbage. Check it out. First things first, wash your hands. Make sure you use a little bit of soap. Make it good and lathery. Make sure you get up the nose and nails and stuff like that, because don't nobody want you cooking that food with some dirty hands. Number two, we're going to start off with our ingredients. I have a half head of cabbage that's already been cut. I have my chicken breast that's already been thawed out and ready to go. I got my noodles, and we're going to use mascarpone noodles. I have my already pre-cut bell peppers because I like to have a little kick to it, like, you know, Jamaican style. Also, we have our cheese. The cheese I like to use is Velveeta cheese because it gives you that nice, creamy, but tangy taste. And then I also add in, you know, some shredded cheese to, you know, add a different blend.
All right, so now we're going to start to chop our cabbage up. You don't have to have it in, you know, small little fine pieces, but, you know, I would say like medium slices or whatnot, and you put them in a pan so that they cook down. So, you know, I start off with like something like this, and sometimes I, you know, may separate it a little bit, but once it cooks down, it's gonna separate itself. So start off by, you know, cutting your cabbage and dropping it in the pan.
You want to add in a cup of water to your greens. Then after you add in a cup of water to your greens, you want to go over them. You want to take your greens, put them on the stove. Start off at like a 6 or something like that, or whatever, you know, medium to medium high to get it boiling first. Next, you want to, you know, add some salt to your mix. Next, you do some pepper. I like to use, you know, Mrs. Dash, because they got all in one in there. Let me do some garlic powder. And you always gotta have Lawry's, because food just not food without Lawry's. So sprinkle a little Lawry's in there. And then to give it that nice tang, but a little sweet taste to it, you want to use some sugar. So I usually do like a tablespoon of sugar. And it takes the tang out, but gives you that nice little sweet flavor. Take some bacon, add bacon to it. This bacon I got right now is already pre-cooked, so I don't have to worry about cooking it down first, but normally if you don't have pre-cooked bacon, you cook the bacon first at the bottom of the pan to let all the drippings, you know, drip out in the bottom of the pan and everything. Then you add all your greens on top of that, and water and everything, and let it boil down. But for now, since I already got pre-cooked bacon, I'm just gonna add the bacon to the top of my greens and let the drippings cook down into my greens. Next, I want to take a lid, put over your greens, let it smother, and that'll get everything nice and soft. Next, what you want to do is, you want to take your chicken breast and season your chicken breast really good, you know, to your liking. You know, to each his own. You know, I know some people like a lot of seasoning, some people don't like a lot of seasoning.
You got everything in a bowl seasoned. I usually take a knife to help tenderize my chicken. And you go around and you poke your chicken here and there. All over, you know. Little, get little puncture wounds in your chicken so that all the seasoning soaks in and it tenderizes your meat. And it overall gives your chicken a better taste and flavor. So, that's the chicken right now that's sitting here marinating. Next, you want to make sure you got a pot on the stove to boil, because you want to make sure you got it nice and steaming hot and boiling ready for your pasta. So you take pasta, which, you know, I'm using about a half a box of pasta, and I'm going to put it in the pudding. Alright, so we got that in there. Half a box of pasta. And I'm going to add a little salt to it to make sure that, you know, it gives a little flavor and also helps the water to boil a lot faster. Now we're going to skip back over here to our cabbage. As you can see, everything is boiling down nice and good. And I can already smell the aroma of how good this is going to taste. You know, you want to make sure you stir it so that the flavors go ahead and, you know, marinate. Next, we're going to take our chicken, you know, that's been sitting here marinating for a little bit. I'm going to take this chicken, you know, flip it around a little bit, a few times, you know, make sure you got the marinade all over. I'm going to take this chicken and we're going to set it in our oven pan to bake. So, I'm going to go over here, you know, space them out, you know, so that everything fits. So we got everything in our bake pan ready to go. As soon as the oven's ready, I'm gonna toss it in. Now normally I take some of my leftover juices and pour it over just so you can have some extra flavoring in and everything. So that's all set. Next, you want to take your noodles that are on the stove that's already cooked down and they're al dente. You want to take these and you want to strain them. And then also, while you're straining your noodles, you want to make sure you get your cheese ready. So I put some Velveeta cheese here in the pan, and I also add some milk to it and let that cook down, let your cheese melt so that you can pour it over your noodles before you put it into the oven to bake. Right now, we got the chicken right here, and the chicken's ready to go into the oven. The oven has already been preheated to 375, and we're ready to go. So we're gonna go ahead and take this chicken and toss it in here. Just like this. Boom. Feeling the heat already. Bam, you're gonna take your chicken and put it in there like that. Close it up. And you're gonna let your chicken cook about 30 minutes. But right now, we're gonna make sure everything else is doing good. So, noodles ready to be drained. Cheese is on the stove right now, melting down. And, what do we got here? Perfect. We got our cabbage, which is done now, already cooked down, so we can turn that off. And cabbage has been cooking here for about 20 minutes. Everything's cooked down and all ready to go. And we can put the top back on there to make sure that stays all hot and fresh. Now we got our cheese boiled down and it's ready to go, and it's all melted. And we got our noodles here in our pan that we're gonna bake everything in. So I take my noodles, it's already cooked down. I mean, well, not my noodles, but my cheese. And I wanna pour it here over my noodles. So you wanna make sure, you know, get it all over. Nice and good. Next, I'm gonna take my spoon here and I'm gonna stir around the cheese, make sure everything is nice and cheesy. As you can hear that noise in the background, that's my baby, so excuse me if you're interrupted. So we got that all cheesy. Next, we're gonna take some mixed cheese, shredded cheese. I got Kobe Monterey Jack cheese right here, made by Kraft. You know, Kraft makes that good cheese. And we're gonna just, you know, sprinkle some over the top. You know, we're gonna stir that in too. But for right now, we're just gonna go ahead and sprinkle the cheese over the top. So we got some of that cheese sprinkled in on top. And you wanna stir it in to make sure, you know, you get it all over. See how it's getting a little stringy? That's how you want it to be. On top of that, what I usually do is I throw a little bit more seasoning in. So I'll take some pepper, I'll sprinkle it in here and there. I'll take a little salt, go like that. Sprinkle it in, and then last but least, like I said, you know, I like my Lowry, so you always gotta add some Lowry's to it. You know, those Lowry's here and there. You don't want it bland, ain't nothing worse than some bland mac and cheese. So you just stir that up, make sure that look all good. Gooey. I'm gonna add some more shredded cheese to my mix. Take your mac and cheese, and we're gonna throw that in the hot oven too. So we got everything else set up and ready to go. You know, safety's first, people, safety first. So make sure you have on your nice oven mitt, you know, do your thing. So we'll take the mac and cheese right here. We're gonna slide it in. We're gonna slide it right next to the chicken, actually. Here's the cabbage, all said and done, looking good and juicy. Baked mac and cheese, scrumptious. And we have our seasoned chicken breast that's been baked, and it's all good and juicy. Here we can cut right into it. Let me show you what it looks like. Make sure that, you know, it's cooked all the way through. No paint, just white meat. So this concludes today's cooking segment. Make sure you tune in next time. I'll show you guys how to bake. Either whip up a nice cocktail for you and your significant other. Tune in next time at your boy, Xavier LT, or hashtag Sexy Black Chef. Stay safe and keep it sexy.